Lucid nightmares feel like you are inside of the scariest movie ever. Instead of you being the one controlling the dream starts to control you. All of your greatest fears come to life, and it can feel like there is no escape. Although nothing can physically hurt you in the dream, some people even report feeling strong sensations of pain. In the dream, you still have some control over the things around you, but there are some things that you should absolutely never do while in a lucid nightmare. Lucid nightmares are caused when you are in a lucid dream and you start to feel afraid. If you don't deal with this emotion right away, your thoughts will slowly get out of control. This can happen to anyone. In fact, around 50% of all lucid dreamers have experienced at least one lucid nightmare. So today, I'm going to go over 6 things that you should never do while in these dreams, so that you don't accidentally do them yourself. At the end, I will also include steps that you can use to escape lucid nightmares for good and make sure they never happen again. Before we get into this video, please hit that subscribe button because I have tons of tutorials on this channel that will help you learn how to master lucid dreaming so you can do it whenever you want. If that sounds cool, then make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications. Anyways, let's get started. Number 1. Don't try to wake up. For many people, lucid nightmares are extremely scary. So you might be wondering, why am I telling you to stay in this nightmare instead of waking up? Well, there are 2 very good reasons why you should stay in a lucid nightmare. The first is that trying to escape or wake up will cause panic, because it might not be as easy as you thought. You may feel trapped and start freaking out, which will only lead to the nightmare getting worse. The second reason, however, is even more interesting, and this is the one I think everyone should focus on. And that is because if you find yourself inside of a lucid nightmare, chances are you were originally trying to have a lucid dream. But here's the thing. In a lucid nightmare, you are already aware inside of the dream. You are lucid dreaming. It's just that things aren't going as planned. So rather than waking up and trying again another night, you can actually turn this nightmare into a fully blown, amazing lucid dream where you are back in complete control. All you need to do is follow a few simple steps, and trust me, it's a lot better than losing all of your progress and waking up instead. If you're interested in learning how to do this, I will go over these steps at the end of this video, so make sure that you watch it until the end. Number 2. Don't look in mirrors. If you encounter a mirror while in the nightmare, do not look into it. This is something that I recommend people avoid in regular lucid dreams as well, but in lucid nightmares, this is even more important. For those who don't know, unlike real life, mirrors in dreams behave differently. They are not exact reflections, but rather will show you whatever you are expecting to see. Many people report seeing scary or even demonic reflections of themselves, which I don't think anyone wants to see. This usually happens because there are a lot of negative feelings going through your mind while you are in a lucid nightmare, and those fears are reflected back at you when you look into the mirror. I will mention that everybody is different, and some people don't have any problems with mirrors in dreams. But in general, it's not worth the risk, especially if you are new to lucid dreaming. So that being said, it's best to avoid them and move on with the dream. Number 3. Don't do nothing. Okay, so what does this mean? If you are in a lucid nightmare and you just stand there, give up, and do nothing, the things that you are running away from may eventually catch you, and if that happens, that will not be a pleasant experience. You need to take action right away, and one of the best ways to do that is by looking around the dream environment and finding somewhere you feel safe. You can also draw a circle around you and tell yourself that nothing can harm you as long as you're in this circle. Say it out loud and really believe it, because if you do, you will be protected. If you're feeling a bit more confident, you can try speaking to the dream characters around you that you are afraid of, and ask them why they are chasing you. This can be a pretty cool experience, because every character in your dream is, after all, a part of your subconscious, so there is always something that you can learn when you talk to them, even if it seems like they are out to get you. Number 4. don't think of scary things. This is probably the worst thing that you can do inside of a lucid nightmare. Unless, of course, you are a sociopath. In all honesty though, thinking of scary things while in a lucid nightmare is just a bad idea, because since you are dreaming, those things will become a reality. So if you want to have the best experience, keep your thoughts positive and try not to be afraid. Number 5, do not panic. Panic is a negative feeling, and in dreams, negative feelings lead to bad things happening. Being in a lucid nightmare can be really scary, and you may have no idea what to do, but just make sure that you remain calm and do not panic, or else things will only get worse. Like I said earlier, in dreams, your thoughts will easily become reality, so be careful. And finally, number 6, don't stay in the nightmare for too long. The longer you spend in a lucid nightmare, the more time there is for something to go wrong. Even if you feel like you're in control, it's still best to change it into a normal lucid dream. Lucid nightmares can be extremely intense, which increases the risk of you accidentally waking up. Now that I've explained what not to do in a lucid nightmare, I'm going to tell you exactly what you need to do if you want to turn it into a lucid dream. There are several ways to do this, but I'm going to teach you the method that works best for me. First of all, you need to get in a spot where you feel safe. Like I said earlier in the video, one way to do this is by drawing a circle around you and imagining that nothing can cross the line and hurt you. Once you are in a safe place, pretend that a small door is behind you that only you can enter. Since you are in a lucid dream, when you turn around, it will be there. Next, visualize a place you want to visit, like Disney World, Jurassic Park, or your own backyard. Just make sure that the place you are going to go is peaceful and not somewhere scary like Mariana's Trench or the TikTok headquarters. Once you have a place in mind, imagine that it is right behind the door that you just created, and then when you are ready, swing it wide open. You will now be looking at a portal which leads directly to the place that you imagined, and when you walk through it, the nightmare will be over and you will be teleported to the new location. From here, you can pretty much do whatever you want, since you are in a lucid dream. You can fly, eat ice cream, meet the President of the United States, and achieve all of your goals. As long as you have positive thoughts, everything will be alright, and what was once a scary nightmare will now be an amazing lucid dream. But that's about it for today's video. If you have any questions about lucid nightmares or would like to share an experience of your own, make sure to leave a comment down below. If you are completely new to this whole lucid dreaming thing and want to learn how to actually control your dreams whenever you want, don't forget to subscribe to the channel because I have tons of tutorials that will definitely help you out. And it would also really help me make more videos like this one. And as always, thanks for watching.